So I remember when I served on the Kentucky Historical Society Board, and there was an exhibit about slavery. And one of the basic premises was that slavery was wrong. Well, that was a really hotly contested statement about whether or not an agency should say that, right? Mm-hmm. Should come out and make that kind of assertion. I think the media faces a very similar criticism of how much do you, so this is where you can say that activism comes in, right? Or if there is an agreed upon set of values, which we don't have in this country anymore, then there would be nothing wrong with the media saying, there is no counter argument about the Holocaust. There is no other fake news. You know, and to find, you know, you've got to find those academic scholastic voices that will reaffirm basic understandings about our history.
And truth.
And truth, you know, and then showcase, you know, the folks who are descendants of and who live through that. I mean, we also have to, we know that storytelling is what makes the convincing argument, that it's not just a recitation of dates and facts. I mean, that's where history teachers have gotten it wrong, right? Mm-hmm. That it's not just about memorize, you know, 1965, mm-hmm. you know, Civil Rights Act, I mean, Voting Rights Act, Civil Rights Act 64. It's more than that. It's more about knowing the names. You know, it's no about, like you said, paying honor and homage to the people who fought. So if we know the names, we'll then learn their stories. But like we try to, I think, especially television news, gets away from the name, the story, the face. You can't just do recitation of facts. And I think if we start giving more than 3 minutes, well, we don't give 3 minutes, a minute and a half on commercial television. Mm-hmm. If you give a little bit more time, you'll get there. But if you're just constantly trying to show in that A block, every murder, every shooting, every theft, every break-in. Mm-hmm. Not saying that's not important, but there needs to be an intentional commitment to saying, you know, these aren't necessarily, these aren't feel-good stories. These are deep policy discussions about what is tearing us apart.
And if you show that A block at 6 a.m., 7 a.m., mm-hmm. 8 a.m., 9 a.m., 12 a.m., mm-hmm. I mean, 12 noon, and go through it through the night, we feel like,
yeah,
we're in a crime wave.
That's right.
But it's the same people coming in front
That's
of the
right.
camera.
And what does that do? It incites more fear about the people that you're seeing on the screen. And that, I should have said this earlier, that is one reason why we started Connections. The way I defined Connections was, it was the antidote to the 11 o'clock news. Mm-hmm. That instead of seeing black people always, or people of color, being in these crime, you know, their mugshots. You know, Christopher 2X is doing some amazing things in helping the community. You know, the late Blaine Hudson did some wonderful work. You know, I have a whole list of people. And so I will say this, the media is some right downright lazy. They want to go to the same sources all the time. If a black person is shot in New York, they're going to go to Reverend Al Sharpton, like mm-hmm. he's the only one. Thank God you got Eddie Barber, who's now on the stage. But mm-hmm. they're too lazy to reach out beyond their Rolodex and look for a fresh face. You know, the Imani Perrys of the world and the, you know, the Dysons of the world. I mean, it's fine to have those people, but you've got brilliant people at Bellarmine, who's doing now a racial reconciliation mm-hmm. course. Mm-hmm. You've got wonderful people at all these institutions. Don't just go to the one that, you know, makes the paper all the time. Look for that person in the community who's doing some good stuff. And Aubrey Williams, who was a gangbanger who was shot, who mm-hmm. has redeemed himself and working with young people. That's somebody to talk, get the other side of the story. You know, instead of talking about the event of crime and the episode of crime, talk about the reasons for why there is crime. Mm-hmm. Talk about the fact that these people have not just poverty and finances and spirit, but because of where they live, that's not, there's no fresh food, there's no sidewalks, there's no safe park. Mm-hmm. You know, talk about those things and not just assail the people for, you know, falling into these situations that sometimes are beyond their mm-hmm. control.